הנני מוכן ומזומן, הנני מוכן ומזומן, הנני מוכן ומזומן, לקיים מצוות עשה.
Why do we sing this song before saying Sfirat HaOmer? In general, we don't have the custom of declaring Hineni Muchan Muzuman, I'm ready and prepared to do a mitzvah. We just do the mitzvah. There are a few exceptions, like when you're writing a tefillin or a Torah scroll or maybe a get, when we say that person has to explicitly state, I'm doing this for the sake of the mitzvah. Why all of a sudden at Sfirat HaOmer do we now say Hineni Muchan Muzuman? The truth is though, when one looks around the Siddur, and throughout many other rituals, we see that there is this Kabbalistic notion of saying Hinei Muchan Muzuman. The origin of this idea comes up in the 15th and 16th centuries from figures like Rav Yosef Karo and Moshe Cordovero, who made a big emphasis on the fact that all of our actions should be dedicated to God, and that we have to verbally express that, particularly when it comes to mitzvot, tefillin, birkat hamazon, dalaminim, and many other mitzvot. But in addition to stating that we have to declare we're about to do a mitzvah, many Kabbalists also added a notion that we should discuss what this mitzvah does for the world, and in particular how it impacts the Esrei Sefirot, the 10 Sefirot that Kabbalists speak about, how the world can be unified in the upper heavens and the lower heavens. Drawing ideas in the Zohar, Sfarim like Reshit Chochma and the Shnei Luchot HaBrit, the Shla, argued that we should articulate this idea of the Shem Yichud Brichu, that somehow that the mitzvot will unify the upper and lower heavens, the Sefirot, and this will be accomplished through our intentional action of performing mitzvot in a very specific way. While all these prayers became very popular in the 16th and 17th centuries, many figures pushed back against them. Figures like Rav Yaakov Reischer, Rav Yaakov Emden, and others argued and said, hey, these are mystical rites that are never meant for the masses. They're esoteric ideas, and not anyone is supposed to be able to say them. B, many of the people reciting these prayers have no idea what they're talking about. And if that's the case, how are you adding meaning to the mitzvah if someone doesn't know what they're saying beforehand? But a more serious critique was offered by Rav Chezkel Landau, the noted Behuda. He asked a number of questions. A, how come there's no precedent for this beforehand in halachic literature? We don't seem to find this notion of saying Hineni Muchan Muzuman beforehand. B, you know what we do say before we do a mitzvah? A bracha. Baruch Ata Hashem Hakem Melchalam Asher Kisham Estav Tzivanu. Why do we need to add another idea of Hineni Muchan Muzuman? And as for the Hashem Yichud Brichu, well, if God wants to tell us what the impact is going to be in the heavens, he'll figure that out for himself. We have no way of knowing what the mitzvah is going to do and put in the heavens. In the meantime, all we need to do is perform the mitzvah with a bracha beforehand. As one can imagine, there's a lot of pushback against the Noda Behuda's criticism, with some basically saying, sorry, if you don't get their Kabbalistic notions in this world, well, that's your loss, but in the meantime, we're going to keep on doing this ritual. Part of Rav Landau's criticism had to do with the fact that he didn't like all these mystical groups. Certainly the Sabbateans, followers of Shabtai Tzvi was pushing up against, and later on, people were also against some of the ritual innovations of the Hasidim. But in truth, if one looks carefully at the sources, one finds that at times some Hasidim said that this ritual of the Shem Yichud Brichu is not really intended for the masses. And on other occasions, one sees even Misnagdim are saying, well, this practice has spread, and therefore we're going to accept doing it. Figures like the Malbim and the Aruch HaShulchan also that we can follow this minhag that's become very popular in the previous centuries. But beyond the controversy over the Shem Yichud Brichu, there's another problem with the text that we recite here, particularly when it comes to Hinei Muchan Muzuman. If you look carefully at the text that we recite specifically before Sfirat HaOmer, there's a problem. The text claims they are going to be performing a mitzvah to say from the Torah, a positive commandment from the Bible. But in fact, most commentators believe that in the absence of the Beit HaMikdash, the mitzvah of counting Sfirat HaOmer is only a mitzvah d'rabbanan. After we recite the bracha at night, we immediately pray, HaRachaman hu yachazir lanu avadat Beit HaMikdash, that God should restore the temple service and bring back the full glory of the mitzvah of Sfirat HaOmer. And if that's the case, the mitzvah today is only a mitzvah d'rabbanan. And therefore, some figures like Rav Avadya Yosef said, well, we should probably change or amend the Hinei Muchan Muzuman. Other figures like Rav Shlomo Zalman Orbach said, well, we can interpret the Hineni Mucha Mezuman in this case to be more speaking broadly and generally about the mitzvah of the Torah of Sfirata Omer. We're not really getting into the details whether it's Derabaita or Derabanan in our time period. But many figures simply stated that the whole notion of the Shem Yichud Brichu and Hineni Mucha Mezuman is just problematic with Sfirata Omer and for any other mitzvah. One of those figures was Rav Soloveitchik. In his book, Halachic Man, he quotes the Nodi Behuda and says, the Halachic Man doesn't need all these mystical notions to prepare mitzvot to the world. All we need to do is do the bracha and fulfill our obligations. And many other Gdolim followed this pattern as well and simply did not recite L'shem Yichud Brichu or Hineni Mucha Mezuman, whether for Sfirata Omer or other mitzvot. There's no really good logic of why we should only say Hineni Mucha Mezuman in front of Sfirata Omer. And therefore, in the absence of a very strong family minhag to recite these texts, I would encourage people to skip the Hineni Mucha Mezuman L'shem Yichud Brichu and just focus on the core of what the mitzvah is about, saying Sfirata Omer with a bracha beforehand, thanking God for having the opportunity to fulfill this mitzvah.
שבע שבתותם אימות מיום אביחם לעומר התנופה, האם...